Hello everyone, today we will learn how to make a controller using HTML, CSS and PHP so that we can control our IoT devices. Using this controller, you can switch on and switch off any IoT device that you make over Wi-Fi. So let's get started. First, we will go to the folder where we have installed XAMPP. I've installed my XAMPP in local disk C. If you don't know how to install XAMPP and work with it, then watch our video in which I have shown how to install XAMPP and work with it. So open XAMPP, scroll down to htdocs. Here, I have already made a folder named controller. You can make your folder according to your choice. Here, I have made a file called index.php. Okay, so I'm using Sublime Text to edit that file. As you can see, in the Sublime Text, I have my index.php file. This is a normal HTML file. Let me tell you that you can definitely use the HTML tag within a PHP file. That is not at all an issue. Okay, so here is your normal HTML tag, the opening HTML tag, the head tag. The head tag is not actually visible on your website. It is visible at the tabs that you open. Okay, so here is the title tag. Whenever you open a website, you can see that on the tab of that Google browser or any other browser, you can see the website name. Like here you can see style.css. so instead of that, here you will see controller. Okay, now this line link style.css, this is the line by which we link an external CSS file to our HTML website. Okay, now here is the body tag. I have used some CSS classes. As you can see in the style.css file, there is a container class. I have given some styling here. There is a controller class. I have added some attributes in the controller class also. So to learn all these things, go to W3 schools and you can get all these things there and you can easily learn from there. Okay, now here you can see there is an anchor tag. What an anchor tag does is whatever file that we are mentioning in the href is equal to, within the double quotes, whatever file name we are mentioning, it will replace this name in the URL. Okay, so here I have mentioned led.php question mark data is equal to on. Here data is a variable and on is that value, which means that when we click on the button mentioned on, okay, I will show you. Like here is the button mentioned on. Okay, so when we will click on it, here after the controller and then slash, a link will get added, that is led.php question mark data is equal to on. Here data is a variable which will go into the led.php file. Okay, so now let's check our led.php file. Similarly, I have also made a button for off, as you have seen in the website, and the data that will go to led.php file is off. Okay, so let's go to our led.php file. Now this if statement is simply for security reasons. Like if we click on this button, if we don't get any data, then this will not run. This whole thing will not run and it will simply display wrong API. Okay, now here it is given $_getData. $_get is the method to get the value from the variable. Now, as I have mentioned here, data is the variable and on is the value. Okay, so if we write $_get and in single quotes data, then we will fetch the value which is on here. Okay, now this is the dollar file is equal to f open led comma w, which means dollar file here is a PHP variable. F open is a function to open a file. Led is the name of the file that we are going to open, and write is the command which will write the data. Okay, the value of the data here is on. So on will be get written on the file named led. Now the feature of fopen function is that if we don't have a file named led, then it will automatically create the led file. And we are using here write function, which means that it will replace all the previous data which is there on the file and give the value of data which is on here. Okay, so now here I'm showing you an example. Suppose the value previously in the LED file was off. Okay, now when we click on the button on, this off will be get replaced by on. Okay, it won't get appended. Like it won't get appended like this if we use W. Now if it gets appended like this, we'll face problem while switching on and off our IoT device using this controller. Okay, so we are using here W function, W in fopen function. Fwrite is the function which will write the data value which we get into the file. Here file is our LED. Okay, so Fwrite will write on or off into that LED file. Since we have opened the file, we need to close the file using fclose function here. Okay, now if something goes wrong, like here we have used if is string, that is only if we give string value on clicking that button it will work properly, else it will echo wrong data format. Don't worry, I will show you everything further in this video, so keep watching. Header location index.php. Now make sure that when you use this function, make sure about how you write it. There is no gap between location and this colon, whereas there is a space between this colon and the file that we are mentioning in this location. Now what happens when we click on the on function, on button or the off button, it will redirect us to led.php. okay, all these things will get executed, and in the header we have given index.php. so ultimately when we click on the on function, it will again redirect us to our same index.php only. Now we will show you a practical example of how it works. Now make sure that you start your Apache server, else your website won't work in the localhost. Okay, so we will again type localhost and the name of the folder where we have made our website, which is controller. Here you can use any name for your website. Okay, now when we click on the on function, you can see it gets redirected here again. So this is the work of location index.php, header location index.php. okay, now I will show you what happens in the LED file. As I have told you, there was no LED file, and now the LED file has been created. So how we will access that LED file? It has been created inside the folder itself, that is the controller folder. So we'll write controller/LED. And you can see here we are accessing the LED file and the value here is on. Similarly, if I press on the off button, go here and refresh this file, so value here becomes off. Okay, so now using this controller, we can switch on and off any IoT device that we make in future. Now the thing is that when we are using NodeMCU to access Wi-Fi or access any website using NodeMCU, we cannot use it directly using localhost. Yes, we can use it using localhost, but that is not a very robust thing to use it. Okay, now we need to host it. Now you may ask that, yeah, it will take a lot of money to host. That is not at all an issue. We will host it on webhost app, which is a free hosting website, and I will clearly show you how to do that. Okay, so now we will open our webhost app website. We'll click on free web hosting. Here you can see n.00webhost.com. click on that. We will sign in this website. We will log in with Google here. Click your account using which you want to log in into webhost app. Make sure that you are not already in it, and if you are already on it, that's not an issue. Follow the rest of the steps to host your website. So this is my new account. So since I know, just click here. Okay, now here you have to give your website name. So I'm giving it Text Thomas. I hope no one else has given this name. Give any password as you want. Okay, so luckily no one has taken the name Text Thomas and my website has been created. Okay, now if your website name is not unique, then it may prompt you to give a unique name. So give a name which is unique. Okay, so now what we will do, we have already built our website, so we don't need the website builder, we don't need WordPress, so we will simply upload my files on the website. Okay, okay, so now here I will write the website name and give the password and click on login. So as you can see, my file manager has been opened directly. Okay, so don't worry about it. Like if you get to see this kind of interface in front of your laptop, you can, or PC, you can see here your website is active. Okay, it's showing the status running, that means your website is active. Just click on manage website and it will redirect you to a interface where you can find your file manager. Okay, this kind of website it is there, and you see you can find your file manager here, so click on that and it will redirect to your file manager. Now where do we need to upload our website? That is in the public_HTML folder. Now here, if you want, you can delete this htaccess file, or if you want, you can keep it, that won't create any harm. Okay, so now we need to upload our files here. We can directly upload our files that we have used, or we can make a folder also. I will show you both the ways how to do that. We'll go to local disk C where our file is stored in the XAMPP and htdocs folder. We'll open the controller and we'll select all the files and open it. Then we'll click on upload. As you can see, the files are getting uploaded. So finally the files have got uploaded. Now we'll go back to our website. Here it is, our website. So just go back. Now how will you access your website? Here is the link to access your website. Just click on it and you see you are able to access your website here. Okay, now see, here is the controller that appears, which we have given in the title tab. So now simply if you click on on or off, it will work globally. That is, if you access this website which you will create, you can access this wherever you want just by typing your website name in any of the search engines. Okay, so now let me show you how will you upload the whole folder in one chance without uploading all the files here. It is better to make folders so that you can upload multiple websites in a single account. Okay, so I will delete this simply. So now I will show you how to make a folder and keep all your web pages inside that folder. We'll create a new folder here and name it controller, as we have named it previously. Created the new folder here. We'll go inside that folder and select upload files and follow the same procedure as followed before. I'll select the files. Here's my controller folder. I will select all the files from my controller folder and open it. I'll click on the upload button and you can see the files are getting uploaded. Files have got uploaded. Now how will you access this folder this website, which is in which we have created a folder. By simply clicking on this website, you won't be able to access the web pages inside that folder, okay? Because as you can see here in the public.html, there is no file or called index.php. All is stored in the controller folder, okay? So we need to type the name of the folder by giving a slash here. As we type the name and it hit enter, we can see our web page loads. Okay, so now you can access this web page from anywhere in the world. The thing is that this web host app is not only for these kind of IoT controllers. Anyone who wants to make their website accessible to everyone around the globe can use web host app. Okay, it is a free web hosting platform. And here you have learned how to create a controller, simple one having two on and off buttons. Now you can make complicated controllers using the same procedure, using HTML, CSS and PHP. You can add your login pages to provide it extra security features. And in the next video, we will integrate the NodeMCU and the controller so that you can access IoT devices using this controller. Till then, happy coding.